Wait, I cannot wait. Oh, hey, I'm Kirk Harnack here at my office for Telos Alliance. And look what the UPS guy just brought. UPS guy just brought this box from, there it is, Telos Alliance. And I'm excited about it. It's at under 10 pounds, and it is an audio console. Here's the inventory tag. Look at that. It is an Altus SE audio console. It's a virtual audio console. It's 8 faders up to 24 faders. I have never plugged one of these in before, so we're going to do this together. We're going to do an unboxing and find out all about the Altus SE audio console. Come on, let's have a good time. All right, welcome into the little studio here where I've kind of gotten ready to put in the Axia Altus SE. We're going to go ahead and open this box up, have a little unboxing, and check this thing out. Axia Altus SE. Nice. All right, and on the back, we have power, 4 different LAN connectors. I think we're going to use LAN 1 and LAN 2, and then a serial number and a VGA connector. All right, so there's the Altus SE. Let's put the box aside, and let's go ahead and plug in our network connectors. We want to put the audio over IP network into LAN 1 and the business network that goes to the internet. We want that on LAN 2. Plug in the power. Now that we're unboxed and connected to power and to our two networks, I want to point out that you've really got to look at the quick start guide. A couple ways to get to the quick start guide. Of course, a piece of paper comes with the unit, tells you how to get to it. You can go to support.telosalliance.com and search for Altus SE quick start guide. You can also just make a Google search for Altus SE quick start guide, and that'll take you there as well. The quick start guide has key information that we'll need to know in order to set this up. And one of the first things we have to do is set the IP addresses that are desired for our two networks. Remember, we've got two networks, an office or business network that can see the internet, and the other network is going to be the Axia Livewire AoIP network, AES67 network. It comes set to defaults for those two networks, but probably they're not the defaults that you want. Indeed, there's two ways to set these IP addresses, and one way is to connect a monitor and a keyboard directly to the Altus SE. And I'm going to do that. It's already hooked up. I'm going to hit the power button. We'll watch it boot up. And again, normally you would not have a monitor connected to the Altus SE. This is just one way to initially set the IP addresses. And look, we're already here at the menu to do that. Let's go to the network menu, and I'm just using a USB connected keyboard on the front of the unit. So here's where we set our network settings for the Livewire network and the office network. By default, the Livewire network is set to 192.168.2.100. Well, I'm going to change that for my network here at my office, and my Livewire network is going to be 010 and then 216. Then 000, and I'm going to make this 012 for the Altus. For the netmask, 255.0 is fine, and I want no gateway since my Axia network is not connected to the internet. And we'll say done with that. Now let's go to the office network. The default IP address, which is 192.168.5.12, I'm going to change that to something for my office, which will be 192.168.0.12. That'll be fine. That mask 222550. And for my gateway, I want 192.168.0001. And that looks good. We'll hit done. And we'll go to DNS. Ah, the defaults that I'm seeing are the Google DNS address. That'll do, but you can put in your own DNS server addresses if you like. We'll say done and reboot and apply settings. So here we go. So there's one way to set the IP addresses on the Altus SE. Let's look at the other way. In the quick start guide, it's called the alternate method for setting the IP addresses. And to do that, we need to have a computer which is already configured to be on the same network segment as the default settings of the Altus SE, and specifically of the live wire connection. So that would be 192.168.2.something. Something besides 100, because that's the default IP address for the Altus SE. And they both need to be connected to the same Ethernet switch. So in this setup, I've got my Altus SE. It's all factory fresh. I've got a computer here that's set up as 192.168.2.222. And they're both set up to work through an Ethernet switch that is down here. So they're both connected that way. So we can browse in to the Altus. And according to the Quick Start Guide, we want to browse in at a specific port number at the IP address. So it's 192.168.2.100:8085. And that's going to get us into the management console for the Altus SE. So with the Altus SE and our computer on the same network segment with different IP addresses, but able to see each other, we go to 192.168.2.100:8085, according to the Quick Start Guide, and the default username is user, the default password is user, all lowercase, but the first thing it's going to do is ask us to change the password, because this is the management console. This is the wrapper around the Altus SE, and this is where you set the environment into which the Altus SE is working. So let's type in a password. Tell you what, I'm going to use lowercase Axia. You shouldn't do that. You should use a more secure password, but I'm just doing a demo here. So we'll click on save, and now it's going to ask for the username, and that's going to be user, and the password is going to be Axia. There we go. This is the management console. This is where you go to do things like set the IP addresses and update the software and things like that. So let's go to the configuration page. And here is where we set the IP addresses. And you can see they are at their factory defaults that we talked about earlier. So let's configure the IP address for the Livewire network. And we're going to change that to be just like I did before. 10.216.0.12. I like that one. And no gateways necessary there, so we'll click OK. And now we'll configure the business network or the office network. And in my case, that's going to be 192.168.0.12, 222550. And my gateway is going to be 192.168.0.1. And we'll click OK. There we go. Now my DNS servers are already set, and so we are ready to go, ready to reboot. And when we reboot, well, guess what? We're not going to be able to browse into this anymore because it will be on a new network segment. But it'll be the network segment that I want it to be on, and the computer I'm using right now, I will just update it to be back on its normal network segment. Remember that the Altus SE does not want to use DHCP to assign an IP address. You really want to give it fixed IP addresses for the AoIP network and for the business network. So we'll say OK, and here we go. While we're waiting for the Altus SE to reboot and pick up its new IP addresses that you just gave it, take this time to set your computer back to its proper IP addresses in the proper LAN segments. That way, the two will be able to talk to each other. Once we've set the IP addresses on both interfaces on the Altus, and we make sure that the office interface is connected to a network that can see the internet, we're going to go activate the license that comes with Altus SE. Indeed, you'll see that license number on the license management page. It'll say invalid, but then go click on activate. It'll phone home and activate that license for you. Then you can go click on the status page and check and see that the license or licenses are activated. Now that we've set the IP addresses and the licensing, well, now we have a console. And there we go. When we click on the service button, there's our console ready to be programmed. Well, how about that? The Altus SE up and running and ready for configuration. Of course, I've configured it here. We're going to take a look at how to do that in our next video, and we can see how to get audio through it like that, and even a microphone. Turn the mic on, mutes the speakers, turns on the on-air light, and you can go on the air on the microphone. Pretty cool. We'll see you next time in our next video on how to configure the Altus console. I'm Kirk Harnack for Telos Alliance.